Hey everybody, this is Tom Tierney back here in the Sony Music Archives, and today we're here to talk about one of the great guitarists of the rock era, Mike Bloomfield. Legacy Recordings has a definitive set out right now that really puts him in the proper place in the pantheon where he belongs among rock guitarists. It's called From His Head to His Heart to His Hands, an audio-visual scrapbook. It contains his solo work. It contains his seminal work with Bob Dylan, including Like a Rolling Stone and the Highway 61 Revisited sessions, the Electric Flag, Paul Butterfield, the Al Kooper recordings, the John Hammond Jr. recordings, all of this amazing stuff contained in this set. And in preparation for this set, we went back to the very beginning of Bloomfield's relationship with Columbia Records, going back almost exactly 50 years, back to one of the documents in our files like this. This is from February 1964, and this is correspondence between Bloomfield and John Hammond, the godfather of A&R at Columbia Records. And this letter in particular from Hammond to Bloomfield, stating that Columbia is very impressed with the audition that Bloomfield recorded in Chicago last month, January of 64. One of the other neat things about this letter is that at the bottom it says, P.S. My son sends his best. Obviously, John Hammond Jr., Bloomfield's guitar buddy, who was playing a lot of the same clubs in Chicago and New York and other places at that time. So if you cut forward about 3 years, by which time Bloomfield has completely sealed his reputation as one of the hottest players alive, and the recording of this album, The Live Adventures of Mike Bloomfield and Al Kooper, recorded for Columbia at the Fillmore West in late September of 1968. The thing, besides the fact that this is one of the great live albums ever, and a lot of it is captured on disc two of our set here, the striking thing about this album, of course, is that the cover is by none other than Norman Rockwell. Now, I wish I could tell you that we had the original Rockwell painting here in the archives that we could show to you. Sadly, we don't. But what we do have is we have a lot of the photos taken for Rockwell that he used as models for the painting itself. And you can see here we have the original print of the image of Bloomfield that was used as the model. And we also have a nice contact sheet of the images of Cooper that were used. The images of Cooper that were used as the model for the cover. And best of all, from my perspective, is we have this, which is a contact sheet of the boys flanking Mr. Rockwell himself. And it's just a great little picture of the two long hair hippie guys surrounded this, you know, little old man with a bow tie on. This is from 1968, and really one of my favorite little parts of the Sony Music Photo Library right here. Anyway, thanks again for listening to this story of Mike Bloomfield. I hope you get a chance to listen to this story also on this new set. I am Tom Tierney. Thanks again, and I will see you next time on LegacyRecordings.com.